What's the number one mistake in cataract surgery that leaves patients disappointed? Imagine walking into cataract surgery with full confidence you'll walk out seeing the world in crystal clarity, but then you find yourself stuck with blurry vision, which is far from what you expected. And what's worse, your surgeon insists everything went perfectly. It's a scary reality, and it's not caused by the type of lens used. It can happen even if you paid top dollar for the best possible lens. It all comes down to one surprising miscalculation that isn't even considered a complication by traditional standards. I'm about to reveal the number one cataract surgery mistake surgeons won't admit and what I do to protect my patients from it. So the national average for cataract surgery complications is believed to be somewhere around 1 to 2%. However, this widely overlooked complication can reach up to 20 to 30%. With over 4 million people having cataract surgery in the United States alone, that's more than a million people affected annually. All right, so what is this widespread complication? It is selecting the wrong power for the lens implant that's in your eyes. You see, each implant comes in a wide range of powers. And for it to work perfectly in your eyes, it is crucial that the proper lens power is implanted. So why the wrong implant power is a bigger deal than you think? In a previous video, I talked about the different types of cataract lens implants you could have and their effects on your vision. If you want to watch it, click here. Now, here's the shocker. Compared to lens power errors, the effects that the type of lens has on your vision is minor. In other words, different lens types of the same power are fairly similar. You'll generally get comparable results if the power is correct. But pick the wrong power and suddenly you've traded one set of vision problems for another. Your post-op vision can end up more blurry than before, and your surgeon might still shrug and say, "Hey, everything looks good from my end." The truth, many surgeons don't even consider this a complication. You see, the standards for cataract surgery have evolved very rapidly in the last 10 years. And what was once considered acceptable maybe 10 years ago may not be acceptable for many patients today. How do we calculate the correct lens power to implant into the eye? We could either use an ultrasound device or a laser biometer. And each has its own ups and downs. Of course, these technologies are now far more advanced and accurate than they used to be. But even a tiny miscalculation can have a significant effect on your vision. For example, a deviation of just half a diopter, that is usually the standard error rate in publications, can reduce your vision from 20/20 to 20/40. Here, we can see an eye chart with the bottom line being 20/20. A drop to the 20/40 line means that now the two bottom lines are blurry and you can only see the 20/40 line. You can imagine the effect that this could have on driving at night or on reading. And that's only for half a diopter. Many publications show that the error could be much larger in many cases. For example, this study from a UK National Ophthalmology Database and many other studies like it show that up to 10% of patients may have an error of one diopter or larger, and up to 30% could have errors of half a diopter or more. What is the effect of a whole diopter on your vision? Here you can see the eye chart again, dropping from 20/20, this time all the way to 20/60. In day-to-day life, that's a significant blow to your clarity and independence. That's why picking the correct lens power is so important. So what's the source of the problem? Getting the right implant power isn't as simple as plugging in a few numbers. The human eye is an intricate optical system, and every measurement, like the corneal curvature, the eye's length, the lens thickness and position, and even your tear layer can affect the final calculation. Add to that the fact that not all measuring devices agree, and you've got a recipe for uncertainty. It's no wonder surgeons often stick to a single measurement method. Taking extra steps to gather multiple readings is time consuming, and interpreting them correctly isn't straightforward. This is precisely why an error in calculating your implant power is alarmingly easy to make and even harder to correct. So, what is traditionally done to circumvent this problem? Let's look at three common ways to tackle this power dilemma. The first method is called intraoperative aberrometry. With this method, the surgeon measures the lens power in real time during the operation. The problem with that? Research shows that this fancy gadget doesn't significantly increase accuracy, but it does extend surgical time and can make the surgery more difficult by limiting the space the surgeon has to operate. What's the second approach? It's called the light adjustable lens. After surgery, these specialized lenses can be adjusted over multiple post-operative visits using ultraviolet light. A primary issue with light adjustable lenses is the requirement for multiple follow-up visits to fine-tune the lens power using UV light treatments. This can be inconvenient for patients and necessitate a strict adherence to wearing protective sunglasses to prevent unintended changes in vision. In addition, light adjustable lenses are often more expensive than traditional monofocal lenses, yet they do not provide the benefit of improved reading vision. This raises questions about their overall value in terms of both money and time spent. Why it's not ideal? It's a lot of extra appointments and adjustments, and you won't get a multifocal option. So you might end up stuck needing reading glasses anyway. More hassle and less freedom. So what's the solution that I use? The standard practice is to measure your eye just once using a single device and then proceed with surgery. But each measuring machine called a biometer has its own unique strengths and weaknesses. One might be better at checking the length of the eye, while another shines at mapping the curvature of the cornea. By using multiple measurements with different devices, I can combine the best features of each and increase the overall accuracy of the measurements. If two devices disagree, I bring in a third as a tiebreaker. This measured thrice, cut once approach, tested over thousands of patients, helps ensure we pick the perfect lens power for your eye, and that means sharper, more reliable vision after surgery. Do we get it right 100% of the time? Of course not. But by using this technique on thousands of patients, our data shows error rates that are many folds lower than any other alternative, leading to better visual outcomes. Subscribe to stay updated about the latest in vision and cataract surgery.